saw a scene so grand, a scene that touched me oh so deep within. A little boy was kneeling there, his Bible in his hands, his little hands were placed beneath his chin.
Amen. So they said, well, I asked people, they didn't better come. Yeah, you've asked one time and they didn't come, so you got upset and didn't want to let them do it anymore. Hello? Am I telling you the truth or not?
You got to work on it.
Maybe three times, maybe four times. Sometimes you just got to keep on going. Keep on going. I'm going to close with this little thing I heard today. Just talking about preacher, he was preaching, and he got through preaching, and out on the curb was a gentleman that was blind, who was sitting on the curb, and the preacher went over to him, and said, sir, do you want to be healed? Oh, yes, sir, I want to be healed. Please, Jesus, heal me. Prayed for him, got healed. The other man was deaf, and they tried to give him something, tried to talk to him, I don't know if they read it, wrote it out or what. Ask him if he wanted to be healed. Oh, yes, I do. Yes, I do. Preacher prayed for him. God healed him, opened his ears up. Third man was sitting there, and preacher asked him, what's going on? He said, well, I'm broke. He said, well, he said, you want me to pray for you? No, sir. He said, because I'm on welfare, and I still get a check every month. Hello. That's the way some of us are. Can I say one more? I was in Mexico. Brother Harda and myself, we were praying for people. I mean, at that time we had I don't know if David and all of y'all were there, but we had it packed out, and people, we prayed for them till 1 o'clock in the morning. I mean, the power of God would hit them and they hit the floor. And they kept going around. About 300 of them just got a circle. Pray for them and start again. I mean, they would have double shot. Hello, double portion of them. But that particular meeting, we went over to Mexico, Reynosa, and so there was a man over there, and we were praying for everybody, and he was there, and we were going to pray for him, so they asked him in Spanish, do you want to be prayed for? He said, do you want to get saved? No, 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 no. He said, why? Why don't you want to, I'm sorry, not saved, I want to pray for him, he could have been crippled. And he said, can we pray for you because you're crippled and God healed you? He said, no, no, no. And we asked him that. Preacher asked him, he said, well, why don't you want to be healed? He said, oh, no, brother. No, no, no. Because I know if I get healed, I'm going back to the barroom and I'm going to dance with the senoritas. And this way I can't dance with the senoritas. He said, I don't want to go back in that. I want to live for Jesus. So sometimes we got all kinds of ideas of what we do and don't want to do. But the thing is, be thankful that you can walk in his door. Some of you have a little trouble, but please, thank God, you can make it. Amen.
Yeah.
Would you stand? Anybody need prayer today? Jerry? You hear me? Come up here, we'll pray for you, huh? Still sore? Jerry jumped out the door the other day and fell on his hip. It's sore. Father, I ask you to touch Jerry right now. The soreness in his hip, we ask you to completely heal this muscle. God, completely make him well right now. He's working for you, and I ask you now to heal him and touch him in Jesus' name. Amen. Now y'all pray for me. My muscles. Father, I ask you to touch Sister Mills right now. Devil, you take your hands off and touch Papa. I ask you to touch her from the top of her head, the sole of her feet. Lord, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, we ask you to heal, Father. We thank you for it. We believe it. We accept it. We praise you in Jesus' name. Thank you for it. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Yes. Amen. God. Anybody else? Hallelujah. Mr. C. How's it doing, buddy?
You spend your money?
What did the doctor say?
You spent your money yet?
Some of it.
You get your, what was it,
$200? All right. You got him off the IV, give me a pill. We'll pray about it and take it up. And we don't have to have a pill, okay? Father, I thank you for healing Curtis right now. You've already brought him through all these things. Now, Lord, I ask you to heal this infection totally up, that he don't even have to take pills. Father, I ask you to heal him completely from the top of his head to the sole of his feet. God, let his vision be perfect, and let him be in good health, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Bless you, God. He nearly lost his eye. He nearly lost his brain. That's a miracle, let me tell you. One day more, they said it would have messed his brain up. Thank God he's okay now. Amen. Praise God. I don't like it down here. I like it back up there. Come here, brother. Sit down for a minute. Move over there right now. Praise God. Anybody else need prayer? Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Father, we ask you to touch each and every one that's here today as we leave. God, be with us. Keep your hand upon us. Keep us safe, Lord, and bring us back at the appointed time. Help us to get all these things sold and all of it taken care of this week. Lord, go before and make the crooked places straight. Touch this family, Lord. I ask you to touch them and move on them to help us. Father, I ask you for a miracle, Father. I ask it in the mighty name of Jesus, and I thank you for it. Amen. God bless you. Tara, the right? Tara, okay. Thank you for being here and the young lady with you. This your daughter? All right. Glad to have you, baby. Glad to have all of y'all. Shake hands, hug somebody's neck, tell them you love them. Amen. Yeah. A little work, a little bit of talking to people and encouraging people. You know,
yeah.
And so I'm just gonna believe it. I don't believe you allowed us just to move just for fun. How many know?
Right.
When you get to the place where God wants you, that's what we want.
Yeah. I'd like to see my daddy say before it's too late. So please, dear God, help my daddy find way before my mother passed away. She took me by my hand with tear-filled eyes. She took